happy Friday. Welcome to another Friday Fast Facts at the Ermatinger House. Today's video is going to be looking into a little more of the history of Francis Ermatinger and the Ermatinger family. I was inspired by watching Hamilton this last weekend, and in the closing scene, there's a song, and in the song, there's a line that says, "Who tells your story?" And it really got me thinking about historic houses in general and how these walls hold a lot of stories that we know nothing about. But it also got me thinking about the fact that a house like this, Ermatinger House, is still here today, even though Francis Ermatinger only lived in Oregon City for 4 years. So we're lucky that it's here and that we still get to tell this unique story that is a part of Oregon City's history. So I'm just gonna talk about Francis Ermatinger and a little bit of his background today. So this is a picture on one of our interpretive panels in our museum of Francis Ermatinger. If you've watched our Friday Fast Facts, you've probably seen this before. But anyways, he was born in 1798 and was actually born in Portugal. His father was Swiss and his mother was Italian. So there's a lot of mix of things going on there. And Francis Ermatinger and his brother Edward both started working for the Hudson's Bay Company in 1818. Prior to this, they were educated in England and they actually come from a family of fur traders. So their father, Lawrence Edward Ermatinger, also worked in the fur trading business as well as their grandfather. So they came from a family of fur traders. Other Ermatinger relatives also worked in the fur trading business. It wasn't until 1821 that the Northwest Company merged with the Hudson's Bay Company. So a lot of their family worked for the Northwest, but Francis and his brother Edward worked for the Hudson's Bay Company, starting off as clerks in 1818. And that is what brought them here to North America. Okay, so now I'm gonna go over just a quick timeline of Francis Ermatinger's career with the Hudson's Bay Company. And then looking at this map showing just how far and often he traveled as an employee with HBC. So 1821, Hudson's Bay Company merged with Northwest, and Francis Ermatinger was assigned to the York factory off the Hudson's Bay. A few years later, him and his brother Edward were assigned to the Columbia District, working at the trading post in Astoria. And then after that, in 1832, Francis Ermatinger was assigned to work off of the Missouri River, and he helped with trading with the Flathead Indians there. And he was there until 1838. Then he made his way over to what's now Idaho in Boise, working at Fort Hall. This is when he was promoted to chief trader. And after this is when he's made his way back to the Columbia District, working out of Fort Vancouver. And a little bit after that, made his way to Oregon City in the early 1840s. I mentioned he was only in Oregon City a few years. So he was in Oregon City and then was reassigned to Fort Chippewyan. He was there for a few years, and then he did take a year furlough. After that, he took his last assignment with the Hudson's Bay Company down here at Fort William. This was in 1852. He worked out of Fort William for 1 year and then retired in 1853. So as you can see from that, he went here to here to here. So he is definitely known for traveling thousands of miles within the Hudson's Bay Company. Okay, so what did Francis Ermatinger do while he was in Oregon City? So he arrived in this area in 1843 about, and he came here to manage a Hudson's Bay Company store. This house, the Ermatinger House, was also built by the Hudson's Bay Company for an employee, and he happened to be that employee. He also very quickly got involved with helping form the first forms of government in Oregon City. Being a new city, there was not a local government yet, so he was a part of meetings to establish that. In 1844, he wrote the first petition to incorporate Oregon City, which there's a photocopy of right there on our panel. This was likely written in this room, and it also is the first existing document of Oregon City. It was not adopted, but then 6 months later, Oregon City became the first city in this territory. A year later, in 1845, he was elected treasurer for the local provisional government here in Oregon City. He ran against Philip Foster, who was a pioneer that came over on the Oregon Trail. So there was a little bit of conflict there between the pioneer American, and Francis Ermatinger being a British Hudson's Bay employee. And then that same year in 1845 is when the coin toss took place to name the city of Portland, which some people think happened here in the Ermatinger house. Even if it didn't, Francis Ermatinger likely would have been at the dinner party when it did happen. So he was very involved in the early happenings of Oregon City, but a lot of people don't know that. So that's why I wanted to talk about that a little bit today, to kind of tell his story and how it fits into our city's history.